behind us there is called the pivot sliders. There's four panels that track on an automated truss. Actually, the panels has a pivot mechanism as well, so they're not only track on, but they can actually change direction as they come on, spin around 180 degrees. So they're used as a
sliders rotating
mid-stage wall during the show. So we use them as a bit of a wall, so we, you know, set other scenes behind it, open the wall up again, cars come through, other scenery tracks down. Scene changes are all automated, so they all track on by motors that are built into the sets for smooth scene changes. We hope that we present a seamless performance, which I'm guessing there's a lot of flown cues and automation cues, there's a lot of scene changes, so I'd say about 50 different looks. We would have had 150 people all up in all the departments, so rigging, lighting, sound, staging, a lot of people involved. So we bring over about 80 and put on the rest of the numbers with local crew, and they've done a fantastic job. So everything you see behind what we call our false proscenium, which is the grey rectangular structure here, everything upstage of that is the same. What we did here is we've actually custom built a proscenium environment here for Manila and Singapore. You see a model over here of that. So that's actually brand new. So this hasn't actually been seen before, this part of the set. So it's actually the first time we've ever installed it, and yeah, it's pretty cool. So there's some lighting built into the set. So any minute now you might see the crew, they'll set what's called the barricades, which are the iconic piece of scenery in Les Mis. You may have seen the old version of Les Mis, which had a giant turntable on stage and the barricades came around. This is a brand new design by Matt McKinley out of the UK. There's no revolve, but there is a tracked barricade that drives downstage. It's very ominous and imposing. And the guys are actually going to set it up. The projection's beautiful. Yeah, it's a really good design. So on a standard production, you would have flown backdrops that are usually made out of a muslin, painted backdrops. But on Les Mis, we have a solid back wall that stays there the whole show. We've got projectors mounted front of house. We also have a projection truss on stage, and they actually project different images onto the upstage wall, many of which were actually Victor Hugo's paintings. He was actually a well-known artist as well as a writer. So some of the images, if you actually look at them close enough, they actually shift, they actually move a little bit as you watch them. So I really like the effect, it looks fantastic. And it's utilised to a very stunning effect on the transition into the sewers in Act 2. It's a very cool scene change.